Corporation of America presents The Magic Key. Facilities of the Radio Corporation of America, the Magic Key of RCA turns to present an hour of entertainment featuring Helen Jepson, lovely star of the Metropolitan Opera, that great master of the piano, Harold Bauer, Le Petit Mirsha, sensational European boy soprano singing from Budapest, the molten harmonies of Fats Waller and his rhythm, Hugh O'Connell, comedy star of this year's Ziegfeld Follies, and Frank Black and the NBC Concert Orchestra opening the program with Stardust from Luigini's brilliant ballet Rook.
Sopranos usually do their singing in church choirs. But in Europe this year, a 10-year-old Romanian, affectionately known as Le Petit Mirsha, is the current sensation of the theatrical world. His voice, high in range and beautiful in tone, so closely resembles the voice of an accomplished woman singer that audiences are amazed. There's a story that a certain star soprano, who just heard him give one of his famous imitations of her, cried out, "Why, he sings more like me than I do myself." On our program today, Le Petit Mirsha makes his American debut. In order that you may form your own opinions of this newest European star, we take you across 4,000 miles of sea and land to the glamorous capital of Hungary, where Le Petit Mirsha is now on tour. The Magic Key turns to Budapest.
Hello, America. We are taking you now across 4,000 miles of sea and land to the glamorous capital of Hungary, where Le Petit Mirsha, the little Romanian boy singer, is now on tour. The Magic Key turns to Budapest. You will hear now Maman, je vais faire la maison by Mirsha and accompanied by Mr. Thibault Folgard.
¶¶ maison est à vendre, la maison est à prendre, il veut le battre sa maison. Il y a même un autre temps pour dire que non.
À la maison. Un Lyonnais, vieni, vieni. Two songs by Litvinovka, the little Romanian boy singer, accompanied by Mr. Isidor Polga. The Magic Key turns now back, feeding you to New York.
We are back in Radio City, headquarters of the family of RCA, whose members unite each Sunday in presenting these programs for the interest and pleasure of families everywhere.
Thank you.
Debussy was his admirer. Ravel dedicated the famous piano composition to him. The French government, in recognition of his artistic services, conferred upon him the Legion of Honor. And music critics all over the world unite in his praise. Yet Harold Bauer remains the same thoroughly unassuming, modest person he was when he first came to America from England 36 years ago. Mr. Bauer started his musical career as a child prodigy, but of the violin. His emergence as a concert pianist dates from the time when Paderewski heard him accompany a singer in an emergency. Upon Paderewski's advice, Bauer turned to the study of the piano. Sensational successes in Berlin, London, Paris, and Boston, and a score of other cities, amply confirmed him in his new career. Mr. Bauer has since played with all the important orchestras of the world and has shown himself the perennial favorite of the concert stage. The Magic Key of RCA turns to one of its most distinguished Victor recording artists, Harold Bauer. Mr. Bauer has chosen for his first selection this afternoon Chopin's famous Scherzo. Thank you. encore, the great American pianist Harold Bauer plays Träumerei by Schumann.
Approximately 25 million radio sets are in use in this country today. Some are old, some new. Some are in perfect condition. But others spoil the enjoyment of even the finest radio programs with crackles, squeals, and fading. It is because of this, because the public, through simple failure to call in a radio service engineer, is missing out on millions of dollars worth of entertainment, that the present week has been officially designated National Radio Service Week. Throughout the country, organized radio service engineers are meeting for discussion of new and better ways to serve their communities. One such meeting is now in progress in Galveston, Texas. To radio service engineers assembled there and to others everywhere, the Radio Corporation of America extends its congratulations for the fine work they are doing. May we suggest that you, personally, take just one instant to reflect whether your set is performing as well now as it did when you bought it. How about it? Does your radio need attention? In honor of National Radio Service Week, all RCA radio tube dealers are offering a special 10-point radio checkup for only $1.50. This checkup includes cleaning, testing, and adjusting your set, and assures you vastly improved reception. Why not call in your nearest RCA radio tube dealer tomorrow? Ask for a checkup and be yourself one of the first to benefit by National Radio Service Week.
Selection just played for you by the NBC Concert Orchestra under the leadership of Frank Black, director of music for the National Broadcasting Company, was Malagania from Moskovsky's opera Boabdia. Magic Key, unlocking a world of entertainment, presented for your interest and pleasure by members of the family of RCA, who individually and collectively offer you every service in radio. All right.
writer and singer, orchestra leader and expert performer on the violin, piano, and organ, master of ceremonies extraordinary. That's Fats Waller. At least those are a few of the accomplishments of this popular Victor recording artist. The son of a minister, Fats Waller was originally intended to follow in his father's footsteps, but rhythm claimed him. Over parental protest, he accepted an offer to sing and play at a cabaret. And that's how Fats Waller and his rhythm was born. Popular now both here and abroad, on the stage and in nightclubs, over the air and on the screen, Fats Waller and his rhythm have been responsible for the success of many of our recent song hits. In fact, I'm going to sit right down and write myself a letter as a perfect example of this type of man-made song. And Fats Waller is the man who made it. Until he gave his distinctive version of this melody to the world on a Victor recording, it had languished in practical obscurity for almost a year. But you all know of its leap to popularity, and now we hear the reason. Fats Waller and his rhythm in person. You want another? Well, here it is. Fats Waller and his rhythm, popular Victor Recording Dance Orchestra, play the weirdest, hottest tune since 1492, Christopher Columbus.
Yes, it is. Let's go.
Mr. Christopher Columbus sailed the sea without a compass. When his men began to rumble, yes.
Up spoke Christopher Columbus, yes, yes.
Somewhere until we get there, we will not go wrong if we sing, swing a song.
Since the world is round, though, we'll be safe and sound, though.
Till our goal is found, though, we'll keep rhythm bound, though. Soon the crew was making merry.
Dash, yeah.
Then came a yell for Isabel, and they brought on the rum in Isabel. No more mutiny, no. What a time it be. With diplomacy, Christie made history, yeah. Mr. Christopher Columbus, yeah. Use rhythm as a compass. Music ended all the rumpus. Why, old Christopher Columbus, latch on, Christy, yeah. That's what I'm talking about. Columbus sailed ocean blue. What I say?
Who put the kick in this year's Ziegfeld Follies? Well, lots of people spell the answer with an O apostrophe C-O-N-N-E-L-L. Hugh O'Connell, of the round face and the good-natured mien. He is at any rate one of America's most popular comedians. Starting his professional career as a proficient comer-outer from under beds and farces, he's kept right on supplying the comedy in stage hit after stage hit. Recently, Hollywood drafted him to star in films, but the Ziegfeld Follies brought him back to his old stamping ground, Broadway. Today, we introduce him to the vast radio audience, which has up till now had too few opportunities to enjoy him. The Magic Key of RCA turns to Hugh O'Connell. Mr. O'Connell appears in a skit by the famous playwright George S. Kaufman. It's titled, If Men Played Bridge Like Women Do. Hugh O'Connell and Company.
And don't forget, I want things served very nicely. Use the best china and the filigree doilies. And at 11 o'clock, just put the cigars and drinks right on the table and we'll stop playing. Come in. Oh, hello, Bob.
Hello, John. I thought I'd run over early to see if I could help you with the lunch.
Thanks. Everything is ready. I baked the cake. Oh, say, that's a new hat, isn't it?
I know. No, don't you remember? It's the one I got last spring. Then when they began wearing bands higher, I said to myself, why should I buy a new hat? Well, I can have a man in and get him to put on another band for me just as easily as not. You like it?
Very attractive. I wonder how it'd look on me.
Well, try it on.
What do you think?
Oh, lovely. Yeah. Makes your face a lot thinner. Who's playing tonight?
George and Mark.
Oh, really? Say, tell me, don't you think George is looking older these days?
Oh, poor George.
How are he and Ethel getting along? Any better?
Not as good.
Funny what she saw in him.
Come in.
Hello, boys.
Oh, hello. Hello, George.
Hello, George. Why, I never saw you look so young.
Say, I just met Ed Jennings down the street, and what do you think? He says Jim Perkins told him that Will Harper's wife may leave him.
You don't say so.
Mm-hmm. What do you think of that? The room looks lovely, John. You've changed things around, haven't you? Awfully nice. But if you don't mind, just a little suggestion. I'm not sure I like that table up there where you've got it. And if you had those chairs reupholstered in blue.
Well, what do you think of plain chintz?
That would be nice. Oh, say, Bob, I've got a TL for you.
Oh, good. What is it?
Well, you owe me one first.
Oh, no, tell me mine. Now, don't be mean.
Well, all right. Frank Williams said you looked lovely in your dinner coat.
Now, that is nice, isn't it?
How's the baby, George?
Awfully cranky lately. He's teething. We left him with the nurse tonight. First chance I've had to get out. Who else is coming?
Just Mark.
Oh, is he? I want to speak to you boys about Mark. Don't you think he's been seeing an awful lot of that Fleming woman lately?
He certainly has. He was at the Biltmore having tea with her yesterday. I know because a cousin of Tom Hennessy's saw him.
Which cousin is that?
Oh, I don't know whether you know him. Ralph Wilson. He married that Akron girl, you know. They have two children.
You remember, one of them is backward.
Oh, yes. I heard of it. Come in.
Hello, everybody.
Oh, hello, Mark.
How are you?
Oh, I'm sorry to be the last, but we have a new maid. You know what that means.
I know. That's all right. Say, I like the cut of that vest, Mark.
Mm-hmm.
Look, boys, don't you like that vest?
Mm. It's nice, isn't it?
Oh, lovely. Turn around and let me see the back.
I made it right in the house. I have a little tailor that comes in. Only $4 a day.
Oh, excuse me. Little spot.
Oh, thanks.
Well, shall we play a little poker?
Yeah, sure. Oh, John, may I trouble you for a glass of water?
Why, of course, Mark.
I'll get it myself. You'll tell me where.
Oh, no, that's all right.
Now,
John doesn't look well, does he?
No. You notice those lines? He can't hide them much longer.
He was very good looking as a boy.
Isn't this room the most terrible thing you ever saw?
I really wanted to get that water myself. I'd like to see his kitchen.
Here you are, Mark.
Oh, thanks, John. Thanks.
Is it cold enough, Mark?
Oh, yes. Of course, I generally put ice in it myself.
Say, we had the loveliest new dessert tonight.
Well, yeah, well, what was it? It's awfully hard to find a new dessert.
Is it?
Well, it was sort of a prune whip. You make it out of just nothing at all, and then a company comes, and you don't expect them.
I want that recipe.
How many eggs?
Does it take much butter?
Oh, no, very little. I'll bring you the recipe Tuesday afternoon.
Well, are we ready?
No, just wait a minute. I want to put this table cover on. There we are.
That's nice, John. Where'd you get it?
Why, I bought a yard of this plain sateen down at Wimble's.
Really? How much was it?
$1.63. It was reduced. And I had this edging in the house.
Awfully nice.
Oh, say, Walter Sharp just got back from Paris.
He did?
Yes. Well, he says they're wearing trousers longer over there.
Really?
Well, what do we play for?
Well, what's the difference? 1 cent limit?
Does it matter who deals?
Say, did you hear about Eddie Parker?
No.
Well, it seems he saw those advertisements about how to get thin, and he thought he'd try them. You know, Eddie's taken on a lot of weight since his marriage.
20 pounds, absolutely.
Well, they sent him some powders, and he began taking them, and... What do you think?
Well, you don't say.
What was it? What was it?
Yeah. Tell us.
Oh, well, who has the cards?
Here they are.
I don't want to play late. I've been shopping all day.
Yes, and I have an appointment at the barber's tomorrow. I'm going to try a new way of getting my hair cut.
Well, which is higher, aces or kings?
Now, let me see. Who bets first?
Are these funny little things clubs?
What are the chips worth?
Let's have them all worth the same thing.
A penny apiece.
Say, Bloomingthal's are having a wonderful sale of nightgowns.
Say, what do you pay your maid?
65, but she isn't worth it.
And these nightgowns...
Boys, listen to this.
You can't do anything about
boys,
it.
Well?
I knew there was something I wanted to tell you.
What is it?
Well, now, in the first place, you must promise not to breathe a word of it to anybody because I got it in absolute confidence and I promised I wouldn't tell.
What is it?
Well, go on.
It's about Sid Heflin. Now, you won't tell anybody. At least don't let on you got it for me.
No.
Well, I'm told, and I got this pretty straight, mind you, I'm told that he's going to...
I don't believe it.
Mm-hmm. When? In April.
April?
I got it. No, why?
A perfect harmony of beauty, manner, voice, and charm is the priceless natural heritage of Helen Jepson, radiant new star of the Metropolitan Opera. Yet success did not come easily to her. She had need of all her American-born determination. Fascinated by music from her earliest youth, studying constantly to educate and improve herself, she got her first real job as a clerk at $15 a week, selling phonograph records in a music shop. She little dreamed that someday the situation would be reversed and her own Victor recordings would be popular from one end of the country to the other. Still, she kept right on studying, saving her money, and when her chance finally came, she was ready for it. The Curtis Institute in Philadelphia granted her first an audition and then a 5-year honorary scholarship. Graduating, she got an engagement with the Philadelphia Opera Company, went on from that to radio work, was overheard by Gatti Katsatsa, and suddenly found herself the possessor of a Metropolitan Opera contract. Now, Miss Jepson is known as the outstanding new personality of the music world. The Magic Key of RCA turns to Helen Jepson. Miss Jepson lends the beauty of her soprano voice to the gavotte from Massenet's well-known opera, Manon. Encore, Helen Jepson, new and radiant Metropolitan Opera star, has chosen a favorite song of her own by Johann Strauss, Tales from the Vienna Woods, arranged by LaForge. ¶¶
In the great scientist's laboratory, there comes that final hushed, expectant moment. Then a contact is made, a tiny spark flashes, two metals fuse, and a new triumphant discovery is added to the roster of modern scientific miracles. But have you ever stopped to think what happens after that? Who carries on? In what manner are the benefits of that discovery realized for you, made an integral, helpful part of your own life? The Radio Corporation of America has always assumed, as one of its most important functions in the field of radio, this twofold duty. First, to originate through scientific research. Second, to distribute the benefits. Think into how many millions of homes the National Broadcasting Company penetrates. This broadcasting service of RCA comprises today the largest networks in the world. And think how many millions enjoy these programs, perfectly reproduced by RCA Victor Magic Brain, Magic Eye, Metal Tube Radio. Through Victor Records and RCA Victor Phonographs, the performances of great orchestras, singers, musicians of all kinds are now available to all of you whenever you want. And in the field of communications, the modern American businessman can communicate via RCA instantly, accurately, directly, with 47 different foreign countries and with a dozen cities of the United States. So it goes in sound motion pictures, in marine radio, in every field the Radio Corporation of America enters. Its constant aim is to spread the benefits which accrue from science to serve an ever-increasing number of people to their ever-increasing satisfaction. That is why we say, for every service in radio, use RCA.
Thank you.
selection just played for you by Frank Black and the NBC Concert Orchestra was Liebesfreud by the great violinist Fritz Kreisler.
We cordially invite you to be with us again next Sunday when the Magic Key will turn again and members of the family of RCA will present that well-known singing duo, Virginia Ray and Jan Pierce, Colonel Schwarzkopf, Chief of the New Jersey State Police, and John V. Kennedy, noted NBC News commentator, in a special crime prevention feature. Richard Himber and his famous dance orchestra, America's most popular monologuist of the moment, Sheila Barrett. From Paris, Jean Sablon, who occupies first place among French radio singers, and Frank Black conducting the NBC Concert Orchestra.
Ben Grauer.
And Robert Waldrop speaking for one member of the family of RCA, the National Broadcasting Company.